On this episode of the Piedmont Motion Picture Show, I've got an in-depth tutorial for the Mavis Pro Camera App, and that starts right now. Hey guys, Ryan with the Piedmont Motion Picture Show. Thank you so much for joining me today. This channel is all about learning and growing as a filmmaker. So please, if you find this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and let's become better filmmakers together. The Mavis Pro Camera App is a powerful filmmaking camera app for the iPhone. I've had many viewers asking me lately about this app over the last few weeks, and a few viewers have even said that they prefer it over FiLMiC Pro and that they're able to get better images from it. I personally haven't put it through enough testing to determine if I think it's better than FiLMiC Pro, so I thought I would check it out, study the ins and outs of the app, and share with you guys what I've learned. That way you can download the app and decide for yourself which app you prefer. First off, the Mavis interface can be utilized in two different modes, the DOP mode or Director of Photography mode and the full screen mode. According to the Mavis website, the DOP mode has been designed to give you access to all the information a director might have on set, while full screen mode gives you a maximized viewfinder by showing you only the most essential or key information that you need to get the job done. First, let's take a look at the DOP interface layout. Holding your device horizontally and starting in the top left of the screen, first you'll see the memory and battery indicators. Right below that, the setting menu button, the viewfinder shot assistance, below that, the real-time exposure, color and focus menus, next, you'll see the FN button. Below that is the time code and recording info. And right below that, you'll see the vectroscope. And just below the vectroscope, you'll see the button to switch in between the full screen mode and the DOP interface. In the center of the screen, of course, is the viewfinder. And right below the viewfinder, you'll see the waveform monitor. On the left-hand side of the viewfinder, you'll see the exposure slider, and on the right-hand side of the viewfinder, you'll see the focus slider. On the top right of the screen is the audio settings button, and below that is the audio meter. Just below the meter is the record button. If you prefer to use the more minimalistic full-screen mode, everything is pretty much the same, except it's streamlined, and the scopes are hidden. You'll also find the time code and recording info at the top of the screen. In either mode, to change focus and exposure, you can use the sliders on each side of the viewfinder. Exposure is on the left and focus is on the right. Just drag the sliders up or down to change the values. To start or stop recording, just hit the big red button at the bottom right of the screen. To view video files that you've recorded, tap the setting icon at the top left of the screen. Then tap on Files within the File Handling section. Then just tap on the file that you want to view. To change the shutter speed, tap on the Exposure menu icon. Here you can toggle the exposure mode and slide the shutter speed control left and right. If your format resolution is set to 1080p, you can zoom by using a touch command. Just double tap on the viewfinder, hold and drag up and down to zoom in and out. But this only works if your resolution is set to 1080p. You'll notice when you first launch the Mavis Pro Camera app that a few pro features are locked behind a paywall. You can either buy them piecemeal for a cheaper price and just buy the features that you really want, or you can buy them all together in a bundle. The first paid pro tool is the shooting assistance. Tap on the viewfinder flyout menu to access them. Here you can find guides and assistants like false color, focus peaking, bars, zebra stripes, and expanded focus. The next paid feature is the recording formats. Here you can set the resolution, frame rate, and bit rate. Just tap the settings icon in the top left, then tap edit format. You can also get to this menu from the main viewfinder. Just set your desired resolution, frame rate, bit rate, and when you're finished, tap Settings and then Done. The next feature is the audio input. Tap on the audio icon at the top right. This may be placed differently depending on which audio devices are connected. Then tap Audio Settings. Now just tap on the relevant audio input from the input section. Then select Done when you're finished. Now let's take a look at what can be found in the Settings menu. The main setting menu is mostly used to access other submenus within the app, but there are a few specific controls that can only be found here. The first setting is where we can set our recording format, which I just showed you. Next is file handling. There is also an option here to enable saving your files to the camera's photo library. There is a viewfinder submenu where you can adjust settings of the viewfinder like framing controls. And next is the controls and interface menu. Here you can customize different aspects of the interface like the recording tally, switch to a light or dark interface, and choose whether or not to have the memory and battery indicators flash when low, among other things. Below the controls and interface option, you'll see the FN button menu. The FN button can be programmed to perform a single action of your choice, and in this menu you can set it to do whatever you like. Below the FN menu, you can create and recall presets based on your settings that you've set. To set white balance and color in Mavis, you can go about it in three ways: manual, from scene, and auto. To set manual, tap on the color menu icon. Go to Edit, select a set to store a color value, and you can select to use either the color temp slider or a common values picker from the top toolbar. Use these along with the tint slider to set the white balance manually. To set the white balance from your scene or using a card, tap on the color menu icon. Tap Edit, set to store, the value, then white balance from scene. Now aim at your white or gray card, filling the entire frame. This locks the white balance into the set. It will not change unless manually adjusted. Now to set the white balance with auto. Pick the color icon, select Edit, and then pick Auto. It's that easy. Beside of the color icon, you'll also see the color display, if you're in DOP mode. This shows the current Kelvin value in the color preset mode. This measures and displays the current color temperature for you. Before we finish up, there is one more feature I wanted to talk about, and that's the Ultra Sync Blue. Ultra Sync Blue allows Mavis to be paired to a super accurate external time source. This works across all multi-camera formats from large-scale professional cameras to DSLRs and GoPros. This allows you to keep Mavis in sync with all of your other sources. So there you have it. That's about everything I've learned about the app so far. Did I miss anything? Let me know in the comments below, and be sure to let me know what you think about the app, and how you think it compares to FiLMiC Pro and the Moment Pro camera app. I have to say that I find the Mavis Pro app's interface to be a little confusing in some places. It's definitely a complex app with awesome features, but I'm quite fond of FiLMiC Pro and the Moment Pro camera app's modernized, clean interface look. But I'm going to keep using Mavis and see how it grows on me. As always, I hope this video has been very beneficial to you, and if it has, please consider subscribing and be sure to give this video a thumbs up. It really helps the channel grow. Thanks for coming along on this filmmaking journey with me. I am Ryan, and I will see you on the next Piedmont Motion Picture Show.